What's up, guys? Justin here with TheSketchUpEssentials.com, back with another SketchUp architectural modeling tutorial for you. So in today's video, I wanted to show you how to preview flooring materials in a space using a couple different methods. So this is something that I've been doing personally because we're looking at flooring materials for a space in our house, and I wanted to talk through a couple different ways you can preview those materials inside of SketchUp. So let's go ahead and just jump into it. And so when you're looking at a space like this one, and you want to just do a quick preview of different flooring materials, there's a couple different ways that you can go about it. And so a lot of the time you can get images for different flooring materials by going to different websites online, but you get varied amounts of information. And so what I wanted to do is talk through two ways that I have previewed flooring materials inside of a space in our house. So the first is I'm gonna pull over a website where we've been looking at a flooring material. So this is a flooring material that we've been looking at for a space. And so ideally what we would like to see, and we don't necessarily see it on this one, but what we would like to see is we'd like to see a texture that we can download, right? So this isn't going to be very good right here because it doesn't actually accurately reflect the floor, right? So we've got some images over here that kind of show what the floor is gonna look like, but they're at kind of a weird perspective and it's not something we can really apply as a texture. And so for this one, we have to look at what we have available. Well, in this situation, what we have available is we have an image that reflects one of the tiles. Right? So instead of having like a texture like this one that we can apply, we do have something where we can actually see one of the tiles in here. And so what we can do, because we have the dimensions of this tile, is we can use this in order to model out our flooring. And so I'm gonna do this a very quick way because I really just wanna see what the space is gonna look like with the flooring material. I don't necessarily care about it being perfect because it's a quick preview. If you guys are interested, we can talk a little bit more about making it perfect in the future. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna model out a bunch of 8.5 inch wide by 47.6 inch long vinyl planks. So the way we're gonna do that is we're gonna go into SketchUp and we're just going to start, and again, remember that we're just looking for a quick preview is all we wanna do. We're gonna start by modeling out a plank. So I'm just gonna draw a line that's gonna be 47.6 inches right here. I'm gonna draw another line. It's gonna be 8.7 inches. And then we can just tap the R key and use the rectangle tool in order to make this a plank. And so then if we look at the product data, this plank I believe is, it's 7 millimeters thick, which I really wish they wouldn't mix metric and imperial like this, but that's gonna give me a thickness of about 0.28 inches. So we'll just extrude this up. 0.28. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to triple click on this in order to select it, and I'm going to make it a component. And we'll just call it vinyl plank. And so all I'm going to do is I'm just going to make a copy of this plank right here using the move tool in copy mode. So tap the M key, click on the corner, move your mouse and tap the control key in order to go into copy mode. And then I'm just going to type in, once I've clicked again, I'm going to type in ×7 and hit the enter key. What that'll do is that'll create 7 copies. You can see how that gave me a little bit too much. That's okay, you can just erase out your extra. And I'm not gonna bother erasing this out because I literally just want to see what this tile is going to look like. And so let's go ahead and apply a material. Remember, because we made this a component, if we apply a material to one of these or make a change to one of these, all of them will change. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna download that material. And you can usually do that just by clicking, finding a material and then right clicking on it and clicking save image as. Again, we're using this just for internal usage. I have no idea what the rules are for like commercial usage. So if you do that, I don't necessarily know if you should do this or not. I can't really make a determination one way or the other. For previewing a tile in our house, I think it ought to be fine to save this image. We're just gonna save this JPEG image in this folder. So we're just gonna click on save. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna save this and we can then import it as a material. So the way that I'm gonna do that is I'm just gonna click on the plus button right here. And remember that we're in the materials section of our tray. And what we wanna do is we wanna go find that material image file. So in this situation, that file is right here. We're just gonna double click on it and then click on okay. And so now we can take this and we can apply it to this image. You're gonna notice right away that it doesn't give us the result that we want. That's okay, we're gonna go in and we're gonna edit this. So notice that I've applied this to this face. Specifically, I have not applied it to the outside of the group. This is actually on the raw face right here. Well, then what I can do is I can right click on this, go into my texture settings, and I can use the position texture settings in order to adjust this. And so notice how when I click position texture, I get these pins in here. Well, I'm just going to right click, click on rotate, and then click on 90 degrees. So that allowed me to rotate this. Well, now what I want to do, and there's a couple different ways you can do this. So in this situation, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to single click on this pin, and then I'm going to find the corner of my material right here. So I'm single clicking, moving my mouse, and then clicking again. And then you can click and drag in order to place this. So the red one allows you to move this. Well, then we can take the green one and put it on the other corner where this material starts to tile. And then we can just click and drag that up until this tile material fills this whole face. So notice how this whole face is now full, and I can hit the enter key. And that's basically going to apply the tile material. Well, the cool thing about this is because this is a component, if I click out of this, what you're going to notice is this wood floor material got applied to all of these tiles. Well, then I'm just going to use the move tool in copy mode. And again, remember, I'm not trying to be super precise with this. Some of this is going to stick out of my house model, and that's okay. I'm just going to use the move tool in copy mode, tap the control key, and I'm just going to copy all of these until they're aligned with the midpoint right here. So notice how now what I have is I have this wood tile material in here. And again, it's not perfect, but I don't really care about going through and editing this right now. If you guys are interested, I can talk about how to do that. But for this video, I'm just trying to get a quick look, right? So I'm just going to select all of these, make sure I don't have this mirror select or this window selected. And then I'll just use the move tool in copy mode again by tapping the M key, tapping control, and then clicking and clicking again. And then I'm just going to type in times maybe like 8 or times 12, and I'm going to hit the enter key. And so notice how this did create a lot of extra tile material. You can clean all of these up, though, because they're components. You're probably going to have to make a bunch of them unique. I'm not really worried about it because I just want to get a view of what this is going to look like from inside of the space, which I now have. So now, if I wanted to, usually what I end up doing is I don't really like the overall or the top view because you don't get a good idea of what this is going to look like. Instead, I like to use the position camera tool, and I like to click and drag in order to set my camera where I'm looking in a certain direction. Remember that you need to type in a height above ground, so I'm going to type in 6 feet and hit the enter key. Then I can click and drag in order to drag this down. Then the other thing you can do is you can use the zoom tool. And notice how we can set our field of view down here with the zoom tool active. So I'm just going to type in a value of 75 and hit the enter key. It gives me a little bit of distortion, but it also makes it so I can actually see what this material is going to look like in this space. And then if I wanted to, I could unhide my ceiling. I could turn my furniture on. And then I can go up to my view animation, and I can add a scene. And so notice how I already had some scenes in here, but for right now, I'm just going to make this my scene. Well, now that means that no matter where I go, if I want to come back to this view, I can just click on that scene right here. And so you can create a couple different scenes with the preview of this material. And the cool thing about this is what this is doing is this is actually giving us a preview of what the actual tile sizes are going to look like in this space. And so that's one way to do this, is to bring these all in here and make a flooring material out of those. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you another way to do this. So I'm going to go back to my overall scene. I'm going to turn off my furniture. And then I'm also going to take all of these flooring tiles, and they should all be in my outliner. So I'm just going to do a shift click to select them all. I'm going to put them in a group. And then for now, I'm just going to hide them, and I'm going to update this scene. So I want to show you another way to do this if you have more of an actual material that you can apply. So this material, for example, is another one that we were looking at. Well, this one, if you look at the images, it actually has an image that you could tile as a texture. So if I click on this, you can see how this has an actual image. So because it has an actual image, we don't actually have to go in and model out our tiles. And for this particular material, I wouldn't do that anyway because there's so many different textures that make up this flooring. So using this as a texture as opposed to actually modeling out the tiles is gonna make a lot more sense. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the same thing. We right click and we save our image. And then we'll go back in here. Well, what we want to do in this situation is we also want to create this as a material inside of our model. So we're just going to click the plus button right here. This one, we'll go ahead and select our other material. So that's going to be this one right here. And we'll click on OK. And so what we've done is we've created a second material. Well, this one, we're going to apply as a texture to our floor. So I'm just going to click in here and I'm going to apply this. Notice how it comes in with the size being all wrong. And so what we want to do is we want to use the position texture tools in order to set this up so that it has an accurate size so that we can actually see what this would look like. And so for this particular tile material, it tells us that our tiles are going to be 7.12 by 48 inches. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a little guideline over here so that I can see, so that I can see exactly how big this is going to be. So I'm just going to draw a line right here. It's going to be 48 inches. Then we'll draw a line over here that's going to be 7.12 inches. So we're going to use this as a guide for setting up our texture. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to right click on this texture under my texture options. And again, remember this is applied to the raw face, not to the outside of my floor group. But I'm going to position this texture. For this one, I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. And we can go ahead and scale it up a little bit. So using the scale tool just to make it a little bit bigger, just as a start. But in this situation, we don't necessarily want to use this fixed pin mode. What we want to do instead is we want to right click on our texture and uncheck the box for fixed pins. And the reason for that is because we want to set these white pins on the corners of the planks that make up this floor. So in this situation, we don't want to use the green in order to scale this up, but instead what we want to do is we want to, and remember I right-clicked and unchecked fixed pins in order to get here. What we want to do is we want to set these on the corners of our wood, like this. And so notice how what I've done is I've set these pins on the corners of a single tile of this material. Well now, we're just going to take these pins and we're just going to drag them so that they're aligned with the actual size of our material. And notice how it looks really weird until you set your last pin. Notice how I can click and drag this, and I can set my pin right here. And so what I've done is I've resized this material so that this plank is aligned with the actual size of a plank in real life. And so what that allowed me to do is that allowed me to size this texture so that this floor is shown exactly right inside of my model. So again, what we can do is we'll just create another view. So I'll just click and drag over here, set my height to 6 feet, drag this down. Remember, I'm just doing the same thing I did before. So set my field of view to 75. I'm gonna unhide my ceiling and I'll turn my furniture on. So what I can do from here is I can add another scene and move it to the right. So now I have a scene where my tile is in here as actual geometry, and then I have another scene where I'm able to preview this material without having to actually model out the geometry because I had a texture in here. And notice that these tiles are the correct size as well. So this is another way that you can preview flooring material inside of SketchUp. So that's where I'm gonna end this video. Leave a comment below and let me know what you thought. Have you tried anything like this before? Did you know about these methods? I just love having that conversation with you guys. If you like this video, please remember to click that like button down below. If you're new around here, remember to click that subscribe button for new SketchUp content every week. As always, thank you so much for taking the time to watch this. I really appreciate it, and I will catch you in the next video. Thanks, guys.